Ahoj, miss. I'm Zelonius. Welcome to my den. Today we are playing Starsector. 100 plus mods edition. I just realized my chat bar is going to be so big compared to the. Whatever the hell. Okay, we are going to resize that. Okay, first of all, go there, there, there you go. Smallest chat bar, but I don't give a hell. Though to be perfectly honest, I could just elongate it a little bit. Like so. Close enough. It's not going to go over the minimap at least. There you go. Alrighty, so I have some stuff in the background besides the game. However, in game we still have roughly 40 FPS. Okay, down to 30 FPS, back to 40 FPS. Very well, we just needed centralization bureau done. Okay, but is that Heron class fast carrier? Okay, I'm going to check that out in a bit. Un momento. Why, thank you. Nothing new, and let's try that Heron. Oh, the free fighter. Okay, I don't give a fuck about that then. Would be nice fighting actual, proper factions now. I might just do that actually. I might just do that. But first, let me take a selfie and also get rid of some stuff. There you go. Okay, we need to take that ore and what are you doing? Q. Requires an AI core to function. There you go, an alpha core. We don't have any duplicates. Mainly because, I'm kind of relying on just income generating stuff. As in, just income, no actual production. And whilst I say I'm relying on it, I might just not actually. Now, the best bet I could do is get rid of the orbital works or the Minecraft. Sadly, they are kind of providing 30, sorry, 46, 60, 71, let's say 72,000, which is not cheap. However, if I get rid of it and put in Putin, haha. Actually, how much does a. Where are you? Commerce cost single. It reduces stability by 3. And it literally going to increase the income by 50%. Okay. Local income or from exports as well. Because if it's just local income that is going to be increased, then well, we are still better off done with you know. With just Minecraft. And I'm not really doing anything that requires these resources, so. Eh. What I really want to start doing now is increasing the colony amounts. Because I need basically more. Whatever the hell. More commodities. Like, I need to start fuel production, I need to start light industry, and also it would be nice to have refineries. But that means I will need to find a world that has both mining and. So I should probably start taking stuff from the ruins. I mean, it's not going for export. Well, okay, organics is actually going for export. However, I do have infection trade for it, I think. So yeah, I'm pressing. Okay, I'm pressing I, then M. Because M doesn't work normally. What do I get from Freeport again? 25% accessibility. Well, that's kinda useful. So yeah, what I'm thinking is getting rid of Minecraft. Which will hopefully reduce my drugs requirement enough for it to be non-existent. So I'm only going to need organics, which I provide from home. Or sorry, from the other system. Ay, ay, ay. Yeah, let's just do that. Let's go for either commerce. Or maybe refining. No, not now. I think I'm going to put mining and refining on a fridge. Or should I start with. Okay, I'm going to start with tech mining, and when it goes to like 30%, I will, well, remove it. I will also assign an AI core. And afterwards, we are done. Underworld bounties, freelance administrator. Oh, she literally doesn't have anything. And I need to go to Mela. To get my stuff. Fuck, I forgot to get my people! I'm at -2 mismanagement penalty! And it shows! Fuck! Okay, I have this thing to be finished in, let's say almost 3 months. Actually, 2.5 months. So I'm going to do a quick trip to Melloc, get my goddamn administrators. The fuck is wrong with you? And yeah, down to 30 FPS once again for some reason. There you go. Visit Academy, retrieve administrator, confirm. Confirm. I don't know why I put them back there, but anyway. Retrieve officer. Yeah, fucker is cautious. I can make one of the cautious guys into steady and one of the aggressive ones steady, but I don't think I actually want to. It's not a bad idea to have cautious people. Terraforming prospect? 4 days until volatile increasement is finished. Which is good, because that means we are going to have volatile mines as well. Why do you exist once again? To reduce pollution, okay. Oh, what I also need to do is actually find my goddamn okay, I'm going to what? There you go. Now they are making even less money. Glorious. To be honest, the only thing I wanted to do is that's a lot of ore. Metals and ore, okay. I might just do a ferrying thing also. Oh yeah, I let's just say try to improve the not improve the design, outfit the haze. And it works weird. Like it's actually really good at basically stun-locking the enemy. And by stun-locking I mean not letting their flux rise up. But the problem is, it's not really good at dealing the damage themselves. Like, okay, we got through the armor. Nice. We are starting to do extra damage. Very nice. And we have sufficient PD to deal with well, basically these. Sadly, if they have proper point defense, our pilums are basically worthless. But yeah, slowly, steadily, we can indeed defeat other cruisers. Sadly, it's not going to work against larger targets, simply because we don't have enough range. They can engage us with their large weapons, we are doomed. So yeah, this is going into the whatever the fuck. To the shelves as well. My question is, yeah, we have a biggest custom production order. Memory leak. How quaint. Let's quick save. Okay, we have steady 30 FPS. Seemingly. And games like to jump between 30 and 40. But otherwise is working. Okay. The thing I'm concerned with is that I have stuff open in the browser. Browser. Wait, do I have a... Yes, I do. Fuck. Abort. Abort. How should I do this? Eh? Nope. What could I do? Well, I can't put them into stable orbit because, you know, they are, well, people. I can't just put people away. Like, if I try to do this. Huh, I actually dropped them out with cryopods. Very well. Take the cryopods. Yoink. One day is until finished. Okay, you know what? I'm not going to put anything in the industrial storage. Very well. Remember, we only have 34 here. Wait, doesn't fucking matter, whatever the hell I'm getting out is going to have the same. In that case, pack all of this. So, remember, we only need 34. Actually, I'm going to wait for the terraforming thing to finish. There you go. More volatiles, no more organics, no more farmland. Not in the system, but yeah, I could improve farmland. I think, considering atmospheric conditions, we are at 50%. How much do we have left? Well, quite a lot, actually. Yeah, the problem is that I have tech mining regarding credits. Because to be perfectly honest, I don't think we need the gen lab anymore. Or gene lab or whatever the fuck. The question is, do I want to change the word type? Good question. Well, I'm going to wait for it to become size 6. Afterwards, I'm probably going to get rid of the stuff that I don't need. For example, the medical labs. And yeah, I know this is what gives me the clone organs bullshit. But to be perfectly honest, besides the occasional drop like this, I don't think I ever need it. Yeah, to be perfectly honest, I literally don't need these because the quests themselves are quite shit. Hey, at least it's cheap and also increases production. I'm not going to increase your patrol HQ stuff. Yeah. Bar, player, officer, what can you do? Nothing that I'm... Wait, does that mean that we finished terraforming? Well, I could change the planet type, but... Less extreme, mild, human breathable, density. I think all of these are already in there. Yeah. The climate is mild, the hotness is contested by orbital reflector array. We have habitable. So yeah, only thing that I could do to reduce the hazard rating further is building that thing that literally does that, reducing the hazard rating. But for that I would need to find the purple derelicts. Anyway, let's jump back home. Basically terraforming finished is there, so nothing to do. And should I go to Catnapital first, or no, I'm actually going to check out Furry Fridge. I don't need any more pig depositors, I have a lot of them. No more fishers. Here have a gamma core. Actually, no, first I will need to get rid of the marines. Though I can do it here, so. I need the 30 before to be separated. There. Confirm. Get the smaller one. Drop it down, furry fridge. Fuck you. And dropping down my full So what I just did there is dropping down my full experience marines so that that's so big on Ichan. And I'm missing so much. How is terraforming going on? 75 days, very well. We ain't building anything else, however, we are going to get to next colony size at next month 6th or something. What am I going to build? Well, I don't have any ruins, so I can go for mining immediately. I will not have organics, but organics will be supplied from Mela. Or apparently not. Yeah, because Mela is technically diable of Unix control, it doesn't give me stuff. Sedge. I hope that at least they are going to spend shipments from there because they are the closest providers of organics. Hey. What is eating? Medical center. That's cute. But yeah, if that is going to finish, I will build mining. And then refining because I have both rare ore and moderate normal ore. So mining and refining will be the things here. Have I started increasing farmland on the capital? Very good question. Now what I wanted to do is actually go to the fourth colony of ours that I made to be the, you know. The provider of something. What the hell is that? Remora class drone tender. I don't mind if I do. Okay, but are you? Vigilance and Trokarkas. The fuck? What are you? Rammer Impact Destroyer. With a large ballistic and a medium ballistic. And it's supposedly used for ramming. Why? No. Don't need. Tech mining at buzzword. Glorious. And there you go. Colony growth is done. So I'm immediately going back to furry fridge. Shush now. Okay, we have done a lot of weapons. We found a lot of weapons. I should have avoided that nebula. Now this I can't. It's too big. Under construction. I was pretty worried that we have been attacked or something. Alright, new stuff. I'm buying some of them just to have enough. Chimbuko burst laser, sure, why not? Don't need longbows, don't need those, neither those or those. I have zero vipers, so why not? Well, can I have a lot, and I don't need mod diadems. Nor hecaton class torpedoes, nor single sabots, by the way. which, if you ask me, are kinda trash. Like, I presume their existence is solely because Hib is hopefully this is going to fix it. I mean, I don't think we are going to produce enough volatiles for it. But if we will... Also, considering that we are not habitable. Oh, it's still cool wet. Because the battle station is being built. Very well. So what we are doing is waiting for the dense atmosphere to disappear, which is going to mean 50% less hazard rating, aka industrial structure upkeep is going to drop down so fucking much. Then we are going to deal with either the extreme cold. Can I deal with the extreme cold? I don't think I can deal with the extreme cold. I mean, if the volatiles is going to be met, then yes, we will. Otherwise, it's just going to be orbital lump. Less effectivity. The only thing I cannot deal with is tectonic activity. Like, is there anything that can deal with that? Well, not with radiation absorbers. Nope, doesn't seem so. Very well, that means we are going to get rid of 50%. Unless we deal with the shortage, we are going to go with 30% more. Wait, it is actually working, the fusion lamp, I just realized. How does this work? It's going to increase ore, transplutonic ore, and organics production as long as the world is not habitable. Very well, how do you wish to increase organics production if the world is not habitable? Like, only habitable worlds have organics, because organics, well, they are organics. Living stuff. I don't think there are any planets that produce organics and are not habitable. So, planets. Only surveyed. Inhabited, unclaimed. Unclaimed. Very well. So, habitable organics, habitable organics. Other organics, habitable organics. Inhabitable organics, what are you? An arid world. Okay. Organics habitable. Organics habitable. So arid worlds have the possibility to have organics without needing habitable. Ditto, ditto, ditto. Yeah, it seems that organics only grow where people are also capable of growing, aka habitable worlds. There is desertic and arid worlds that don't possess habitable, yet they possess some organics. I don't know if that's technically possible. I also am capable of producing arid or desertic worlds. Skill is also a frozen world with common organics. Is that even possible? It shouldn't be. Frozen world with organics. What the fuck? Yeah. Okay, we are cryovolcanic, so that's maybe that. How on earth are we supposed to be not? So anyway, now we are going back home. So fast actually that I'm probably going to initiate this. Don't care. Terraforming options is going to increase further organics development. Very well. And hopefully we are going to increase farmlands afterwards. What are you? Incendiary blaster. I actually want to have some of those on hand. And also the scalar... sky... What are you? Scalar tech solutions. One of the marks. Mark sieves. And that's about it. Rest I don't give a damn about. So, sold. Sold. Gib. Sold, sold. Sold, 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 sold. There. Do we have any? No, we don't have any blueprints. What are those? Touchy up pieces. Very well. Anything nice to buy? Cheaper rampant. Dominator. Starliner MK2 support package. The ECCM package I just straight up don't get. Why do you have it if you don't have missiles? Like, ECCM package literally just for missiles. I have an idle officer somewhere. Is my idle officer? Yeah, he is the... not too... happy one. Do I have any other ones that are kind of finicky? I found the aggressive one. Well, yeah, but they are strike commanders, so I cannot put them into the. Well, there. What I could do on the other hand is. Sadly, they don't have. Systems expertise. Literally, only thing I need is systems expertise. So, I'm going to check if there is somebody. Well, that's just a freelance administrator. Cannot do shit. You know what? I'm getting rid of one of my commanders. Oh, I'm definitely getting rid of that ship. Don't need. Do I have the? Yeah, we have the rollers then, also this mofo then. And I think that's it from the production. The ship production. Oh wait, no, we are waiting for the Bernard thingamajig as well. Oh yeah, these kinda suck. The... What are you again? Oh, I didn't drink you. No, fuck you. What's your name? What's your name? Atlas. Stupid Atlas. No storage. Why would I try to sell it to the goddamn black market? Are you retarded? Don't answer, please. Okay, besides having a fuck ton of mining lasers on the sides. Like, a real fuckton. Okay, I think the only inbuilt stuff are the mining lasers, and I have 18 of them, apparently. Blast doors I don't need, nor that much capacitors. Large ballistic hardpoint. Okay, I'm going to make you a cheap one. A cheapo bimbo. Because we have three ballistic hardpoints, medium ones and two small. But this, basically all of these are hardpoints. And also fucking locusts. The fuck? And it's so cheap. Like, supposedly this is a destroyer, but I don't think so. Anyway. If you don't mind, I'd... Okay, should I put a minigun in there? Because that would be extremely funny. Could go with this as well. Though it's actually shorter range, so actually no. Oh, mega scatter cannon. I mean... Nah, I don't think so that it's worth it. Yeah, I think a minigun would be just straight up better. Mm-hmm. And the rest is going to be... You guessed it, Andersons. And the small ballistics are going to be, you guessed it, whatever the fuck that I can find on a 1000 range. Which seem to be monorail railguns. Sorry, monogram railguns. Let me see if there are anything else, because they are actually costly, and... Yep, there is nothing else, okay. Find your use, monogram railgun. The medium missile needs to be... If I find it... Yes, you guessed right. Bilum. Or should I actually make it into a one of these? Well, it's Plague Bearer tech, so I might not want to. If I remember, yeah, we have Heavy Nyxai as well. So you could go cheap with a normal Nyxus, or go hard with a Heavy Nyxus. Let's go hard with the Heavy Nyxus. I'm a destroyer, so... Oh fuck, it's going to cost 20. Am I a destroyer? No, I'm definitely a cruiser at this point. So I will need 29. Yeah, I'm going to go with the smaller Nyxus. I need that 5 points. Like, I really need it. There. Because it not just increases the speed by 2, but also increases the damage. The problem is that the flux generation is not going to be better. So I might just go with... No, I'm going to check this out first. So... Locusts are going to be the last things. I'm going to have the minigun attack separate from the Andersons, but the monograms can attack with the Anderson. These are going to go back one. Nexus launcher is also going to go back one. Everything is linked. I can ignore 180 of the flux, but considering what we are doing here, I don't think so that's a good idea. Anyway, I cost a mere 9, but I think we are going to go against yeah, these fuckers. Ow. It's a good question why didn't you raise your fucking shield beforehand, but... Well, the range is indeed problematic. Though on that note, if I would really want to go stupid, I'd remove the Andersons in favor of monograms. Also, what I'm definitely going to do is put the Nyxi on the locusts as well. The problem is indeed that this very heavy destroyer and by that I mean actual really fucking heavy destroyer we kinda messed up as it doesn't have the hull and the flux capacity to actually deal with all these weapons. So yeah, the fact that I can just fire the minigun almost continuously is working. And it would be really nice if I could actually produce them. But yeah, the other option is the Urchin, which gives less damage potential for, well, technically even less flux, but nope, straight up worse flux. Not worth it in that case. Or we could go for a Baffler, with slightly worse flux, but... well, the problem is that the projectiles can be shot down and PD heavy people like people, ships like the Dominator can actually fuck those, but yeah, I actually think I'm going to stick with this. Very good. Now if you excuse me, I'm going to auto-fit you with the pilum variants. Glorious. That's a lot of PD mining lasers, by the by. Like, whatever the fuck will try to get behind this ship is going to have a really hard time dealing with all those. Lightly seared on reality. Grrr. They literally have the same name. Fuck, why you have Nexicanons? Is Nexicanons a thing? No, I should have Bongo Sieves. Fuck, why you have Nexicanons instead? Alright, Williams on more monogram. Well, it seems because we are out of Bongos. On the OG ones, yeah, no. In that case, we are switching to stuff that has barely any flux. Like Vulcans. Congratulations, you have extra 2 points. Yay. To be perfectly honest, if that is the case, I'm just going to put one of those there as well. There you go. Now, I'm going to rename you though. Cat Obvious twin. Because they come in a package. Not... I studied wrong. They came in a package. That's still bad. Fuck. Anyway, what I'm gonna do is take off everything worthwhile, namely these. The PD and all other stuff can stay, and just put them into storage. Yeah, that doesn't sound right. So what should we do actually? We have an extra cruiser. How are we so severely understrength? Like, do they need a lot of people? Oh, yeah, 400 people per pop. That's a lot, like, considering the other more advanced stuff has, like, just 150, but okay. Or 140. These ones indeed eat a lot. Actually, pick C67. I might just switch to them because less people. I literally have nothing over destroyer size. Not bad, actually. Brawler TT. Two medium energy and two medium synergy. Two small synergy, which is missile. 250 flux, 300 capacity, 100 top speed. I mean, it's not bad. Considering other stuff. Like, where is it? Not this one. Also not this one. This one, the three mediums with 300 dissipation. Actually less flux capacity, same top speed. Though it's adaptive as also, eh. How is your shield? Same. Anyway, what I wanted to do is first get more people because apparently I need them. Glorious. Now let's finish that stupid hauling mission to get another million. Get to my... oh my god, 43 minutes. Oops. So, question is, I go there, but is there a gate nearby? It's literally in the Kazilix system that I can just visit via gate. Okay. You know what I'm going to do. You guessed it. And 9. Travel to the gate, to Kazalik system, initiate transit. And Tamil station is the place I need to bring them. Probane error probe. Domain error probe. Probane error probe. Okay. Domain error probes are not really interesting because, yeah, they might have stuff nearby them. Unstable arid world. Okay. There you go, 1 million. I'm getting bongos because they are cheap on the flux front at least. Plasma burster because they funny. And seems like nothing else, Rodemeram. The fuck is this? Why would I want this? What does it do? So a fully enclosed missile launcher, program ammunition with a ballistic trajectory prior to launch, allowing it to fire otherwise unguided ordnance in all directions. So it's basically a shittier, a better annihilator. At least supposedly. How the fuck do I not have enough pilum barrages? Does my... Yeah, they do have all pilum barrages. Very good. The fuck are you? Inbuilt typhoon. Okay. One medium universal, two medium ballistic. Small missile, small energy, small ballistic. Overdrive. Eh. I don't have any of those, so I'm buying them. I don't have any of those, so I'm buying them. Ditto. Buying some ricochets because they are cheap. Kinda low on Anderson as well, so might as well. What is that? One large composite. Two small missile, two medium ballistic, four small composite, so... Six small missile. And a fighter bay. This motherfucker would... actually benefit way more from the ECCM package that the other Starliner has. Which means that the other one is kind of stupid. I think that the two models are from two different modes, so it's not really a problem, but it's sad. Medium composite, medium ballistic, small missile. Okay, this is a patrol destroyer with three mediums. And a lot of missiles, actually, because if one of them is a missile, of the mediums, I mean, that means it has potentially 7 pilum capability. And also 2 medium ballistics to shoot at the enemy as well. This is a heavy frigate with a single medium ballistic that is hopefully on a turret. 3 small missiles and 3 small ballistics. Eh. Not so heavy in my opinion. At least it's cheap. dock sidebar, maybe? Storyteller? Avant that fleet. With a sorry saboteur carrier that has two fighter bays and a large energy, apparently. Okay. Two small missiles, two small missiles, four small missiles, two medium energy, four small energy. Well, sadly, it has maneuvering jets, which suck dick. Also, very low hull integrity. Like, for a cruiser, that's pretty fucking low. Also, low top speed. I mean, I could kinda make it work. To be a proper battle carrier. But yeah, wanted fleet, okay. Where are the bounties? There. So. I think it's you. Yep. These are the Sarissas. Ah, she's my Asuran. Okay. I'm not messing with those. Also out of pirate bounties for some reason. Like, okay, who could I personally fuck without any remorse? Not much. Ah! Well, sadly, it's a personal league ship, so I cannot really touch it. I think. Yeah, we are at minus two with them, but that's just mean we are slightly hitting their guts. Angry man in the expensive suit. No. Disappointed commodity traders. No. Officer, what can you do? Point defense. Thanks, but no thanks. And we have a freelance administrator who can do space operations and nothing else. Eat dick. Very well, your funeral. So we are finished with this quest. Off you fuck. So the next thing we need to do is... either go for the outposts, now that I have the capacity. Okay, what about gates? The closest I could get is my very own, back home. Let's go home, and from that we are going to access our planet. Also not access, go to our planet in Lombi. Longi Lombi, where are you? There you are. Close enough. Hi. Tritakion, what the fuck? Okay, what do we have? Artificial word. Our very own buzzword. Dogos, Andrian Tobak, yeah. Okay, I'm going to do the thing, the 8. Okay. Let's check out you first. No, it doesn't seem to possess any. Whatever the hell. This one neither. I'm searching for ruins, basically. Okay, so apparently we still have an open market, very good. Do we have anything that we don't... Sorry, do they sell anything that we don't have? Seems like it's not the case, we have everything. Very good, in fact. Gnognos more dart launcher, yes! I don't know what they are, but I'm buying them. Gosh log cryo heat generator, of course! And what are you? Kopesh M. No. What are these? Crinkle disruptors. They are weird. Okay, so what do you do, by the way? 600 range, pretty good damage per second for a medium weapon. Very bad flex per second, though. Alternates between kinetic and high explosive damage every shot, does 50% less damage to hull. Okay. This one, homing projectiles which stick to the hull and explode after half a second dealing 50 high explosive damage. So it's 250. Okay, so basically homing projectiles for 13. And it's high explosive. With good accuracy and good turn rate. Basically swarbs without the EMP. And also high explosive. And sticky. Any nice ships? Of course not. The hell are you? Antiphase destroyer with a large missile. Okay. Two small energy and two medium energy with a quantum disruptor. I mean, I could probably make it work with going for full capacity, putting a very high burst damage weapon on there, like tachyon laser, increase the refire delay, sorry, the fire rate. With various stuff and just see how it's go pew 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 very quick. However, with that flux dissipation, I don't think that is going to work pretty well, but I might just try. It's pretty cheap, so yeah. Greyhound, what the fuck is a Greyhound? Uh-huh, so it's proper combat frigate now, supposedly. It has three small ballistics and accelerated ammo feed. Okay, with a medium ballistic. I mean, it's not a heavy frigate, But it is a frigate. Also lacks shields, so yeah. Very much thinking about actually buying one of those. Like with briefly overloading the enemy. I don't know how brief is that, but if we can like plasma cannon our way out of it, it sounds pretty good. You know what, let's try it. So, in any case, it's recharging. 30 fucking days. Is it ready to? It's ready to fire now, holy shit! Oh my god, okay, so. Well, it says this will move the planet towards your closest colony in another system. Which should have been the Mela system previously. Move towards the core systems. Move towards the fringe to a random direction. I'm going to chicken out. I hope it's actually going to bring it to my colonies. Anyway. I think that's all of it that I wanted to bring. I apparently have supplies. Well, thank you very much. Well, I can't really do anything with you currently, so.
Eh.
It has Dome Citizen Atmosphere Processor done, so we can actually. We are going to put pollution on here via the corrupted nanoforge, unless. Oh, it's just on habitable worlds, very well. Question, can I not build a stellar refactor array? I think I did and then later destroyed it because it cannot deal with extreme heat and extreme cold. Which is weird because I cannot deal with extreme heat in this case. Which is weird. Anyway, hopefully it's going to send it home. Anything I want to build on you currently? Maybe assign an AI core. I mean, to be perfectly honest, I don't give a damn about whatever the fuck you unearthed from a scattered ruins. But otherwise, yeah. no one interesting, so off you fuck. Beta Cirrus star system. Okay, where is it? Is it even further? It literally went into... Oh, because I have the thing, the outpost. Very well. Lots of produced machinery, and the tanker is done. How quaint. What are you, a research station? Whee! Okay, don't care. What are you, Suzuki Cloptetron Trauma Projector Blueprint? That's actually kinda sucky, but okay. And Force Overdrive. So, Force Overdrive Trauma Shipyard. Unusual mode of modification for Cassadari hose and refits radiating power from the shields to the temporal conduit grid, allowing for a permanent overdrive activation to at least partially counteract the loss of shields. The saved weight of a missing shields generator is used instead. Mount additional armor plating negate the half of the Cassadari engineering armor reduction. Okay, I'm not going to use this at all because I don't use Cassadari ships. Thermal projector is... the fuck is that? Positron lens. Okay, sprite work needs a little bit more attention. Primeval ionizer! Oh, you fucking bitch! Large hybrid, okay. Requires basic ballistic energy or hybrid thought counts as energy for stand modifiers. Very high ordnance points, okay, range, very high damage, very shit damage per second, very high flux per second, deals 100% additional high explosive damage, okay, very well, twice the damage per second, still shit flux per second, hits ionizes target, increasing damage taken from the threat matching this weapon, I guess energy weapons. By 20% and doesn't stack. Fires 7 fucking seconds. Okay, that's a thing that I'm going to put on a ship. Wait, I think I definitely know what ship I'm going to put this on. Boy. Anything else? Not really. Same old, same old. Wait, Okita, what are you? 5000 range, 3000 damage, plus 1000 EMP, so basically a EMP modified Reaper. Very well. Deals up to 1000 EMP arcing damage on impact. Pushes targets away. Speed, extreme, okay. Unrelenting sprint type missile. Sprint type? Why do you come up with words? Military jargon already has a lot of shit. That is weird. I also realized that there is something else over there. Anyway, sprint type missile that carries a massive AM boosted fusion warhead. The Akita is optimized to deliver killing blow at the first opportunity by offering an impressive speed and decent resistance to PD. Also has fucking tracking, unless the unlike the freaking whatever the hell, the Reaper torpedoes. So yeah. What are you, Feuer Schummer launcher? So it's an anti-fighter missile that basically reloads. And 500 kinetic damage to fighters. Per missile? Or the whole package in general? Because if it's the whole package, then okay, it's not that overpowered. Otherwise, no, it's pretty fucking much overpowered. It's basically PD. Missile PD. And sadly, missile weapons don't benefit from ranging increasing hull mods, so... That 800 is going to stay 800. But yeah. And a gamma core. I'm definitely checking you out. Apparently, you have nothing. You are literally made out of metal. But you don't have ruins. How? Okay, what are you? A nibbler. Don't know what it is. Eating it. Fire class face tanker. Have enough already. What are you? Who are you? Can I deal with you? I will try. What do you have? One of these. Okay, so free fighter base. Five large energy! Oh my god! Can I actually beat these fuckers? I mean, I will try. I will try. And of course I'm going to, no, these two are not going to help, but the other four, yes, they will. Alright, let's assign people. So you defend that one, 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 you defend that one. Actually, in that case, you defend that one, you defend that one. You defend that one, and you defend that one. We are also going to assign additional fighters. To the weaker ones. Wait, no, there. There you go. Sadly, I literally don't have any fleet anchors, so this is going to suck. And there goes the missiles. Yep. There goes the missiles! Okay, let's try focusing fire on this mofo. Seemingly, he's going to have flux problems soon. There you go. Yeah, I think we are going to have this one in the bag now. Tess Andres! Guys, I think we are winning this. Go ham, kill everything. Leave them no quarter. Oh my. I mean, they are going to go inert sometime. Right now, indeed. Oh, they tried to leave. How cute. With their beam frigates and whatever the fuck is that. Just a freighter. Why have you been in reserve? No. Okay, pursue them. Second in command can handle it. I'm sending the small stuff basically with... Who is the zippiest of you? You. Figures. Two medium energy and two smash energy. Plasma jets. Oh yeah, the Kiwi class. It's basically a downsized Odysseus. Okay, the capital frigate. But no, I'm not going to take it now. An Aqueduster on the other hand. Accelerated ammo feeder, 4 monorails, split chambers, the turbo boosters, maybe even weighted. It has 50 ordnance points, so yeah. And also just 4 to actually field. Very nice flux stats also, so... Ah, if I want, I will go on to build them. Continue. Why? He attacked me, you fucker! Yeah. Did I get stuff? No, I didn't. Okay, Scaper class modified gunship with 2 medium hybrids, 4 small energy and 4 small missile. It has maneuvering jets with suck dick. It has a very high top speed considering that it's destroyer sized. Okay, ordnance points. Sadly, I don't think I could make it zippy enough. Like, okay, 2 medium, what was those? Hybrids, so either energy or ballistic, though in this case this would be definitely ballistic. The 4 small energies I don't really think I can deal with. Like... If there is an energy weapon that deals fragmentation damage for significantly less flux, then maybe, otherwise I don't think they're worth it. And the missiles, okay, those are actually useful, but nah. Off you fuck. And I found the mudskipper. Intel too weak, but we are at war with them, so Diabol Corp. Even though I'm actually... it doesn't seem so that it has anything. Oh, mining station. Consider ship recovery. We have a Frond, a Mudskipper, and a... No, I don't need any of those. Very well. Combat drone replicator. That's really, really useful. Uh, Hyper chain, sorry, hyperferrous chain and phase field engine. That's for upgrading ships. I currently don't really possess any ships that I wish to upgrade though, so sucks dick. Alrighty. Anything else? But it seems to be showing something. There you go. There is a something. And it's a henchman class troopship. Nah. What are you? Scavenger. There is something on this planet. Multiple things, in fact. And one of them is an orbital habitat. What the fuck are you? Nebulite. Three fighter bays. Okay. That's quite good for a destroyer, not gonna lie. But medium energy, small ballistic. It has surveying equipment and salvage entry for some reason. What are you? Low-tech or high-tech blueprint package. Contaptor, Cossack and Dragoon. Contemptor, Cossack, Dragoon. Contemptor, Cossack, Dragoon. Contemptor, Cossack, Dragoon. Contemptor. Two small missile, two medium ballistics, small ballistic flare launcher, thermal pulse cannon. Okay, it's a cruiser designed around the thermal pulse cannon with four small missiles and two medium ballistics and PD and fucking flare launcher. No, Cossack. It's a light destroyer with a fighter bay, 4 small ballistic, 2 small missile and 1 medium ballistic. It has reserve deployment, so that fighter bay is actually going to work pretty well. However, it doesn't really possess anything that would make it viable against, you know, other destroyers, so nah. Corsair. See, 4 medium ballistics are going to fuck balls. Also 2 thermal pulse cannons. And the dedicating targeting core. Inbuilt. If it would be cheap or have more ordnance points, I would definitely buy some of those. But yeah, the other was a Dragoon, if I remember correctly, which is going to be right here. Which is literally the previous one, but with 2 medium spots and even less ordnance points, I think. Like, how is this a destroyer besides having 2 composite mediums? I think it barely works as a destroyer. What the fuck is this? Draft. Frigate with a solid front, a perfect capable of absorbing a large amount of damage for its class.
Nah, it literally doesn't have any shields. Shitty armor rating, not much heart. Nah.
I mean, compared to stuff like the Dove, of course. or for a dram, then sure, it's like half a thunder minus shields. With shields it would be pretty good, without shields, no. I mean, it can restore itself, but it doesn't have the hull integrity just to withstand damage enough. At least it has a fuck ton of missiles. And a medium to boot. But yeah, the stuff I found now is kinda shitty. Very well. At least we know now. No. Nov? Knov? That I can defeat a proper fleet with just this. Which is nice. Incredibly nice, in fact. Because most of the damage is done by my shields. Oh, sorry, my missiles. Why is everybody suspend repairs? Control G. G, 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 G. Yeah, resume more repairs. Why haven't you been repairing stuff? It's weird. Now that was quick. I think it doesn't possess anything else, the system I mean. So we are going to that other system. The circus one. We already... have... a outpost here, and I think that was what fucked over the rift. I really should not cross the fucking black hole. Ah, create volcanic world, okay. Please have stuff that I can just leave. Yep, thank you. Now I'm going to dismantle my fucking outpost. Well, apparently size 2 already. Which means it has hundreds of people. Yay! Question. They eat 5,000 each. But no, I don't think they're really useful. I have enough fuel to go wherever I want, basically. Besides those three very far away systems. A bit. I think if I start mucking around in this system, I'm eventually going to find the pink derelicts or purple derelicts. But yeah, otherwise I'm going to dismantle the fucking outpost. What the fuck is that? Seems like stations. Ground defense is done, now doing Doom Cities. Yay! I really need to get you back to wherever the fuck you were. How long until the regenerator? Okay, before that I'm going to check out some stuff. This seems to be the stuff I already possess. What are these? Arbitrators. Very well. Oh, overcharged torches. Yeah, sure. I mean, they are nice. I just don't really use them much. More Ravager models. Cobras and defense pods. And not much else. So, how long until you are recharging? One more month. Well, I have the money, so I'm definitely going to build an orbital post right here. Just for the plus 3 stability bonus. Otherwise, I don't want to change the planet type, especially into these, because they are going to become habitable. Can't even make them into fucking arid types. Can make them into a frozen world, though. What about tundra? Well, most of the problem is that it's very hot. Very well. No? Haha, a barrage. A lot of demons. What are you? Two medium ballistic, one small missile, two small ballistic. Accelerated ammo feeder! Now, granted, I don't know which mod is this from, because the which mod thing doesn't really... What's it called? Identifying it. But yeah. Override core even. Fuck you then. Ay. Pressure across heavy pursuit frigate hull. With top speed of 105. But you are not going to pursuit drive. Ship engines to 40% enemy craft while still allowing the ship to maneuver. Any collisions runs the risk of flameout. So matching the speed or something? It has one medium composite, which in this case might be even made into proper medium ballistic. Because it's not really useful as a missile ship. The fuck are you, crook? Medium missile, heavy warrior drone. Fuck you then. Spades, blitzers, and steves. Large composite. I mean, if you put a pilum barrage on there, it's definitely going to work, yes. Well, sadly, I will need to burn world. Radiation from the nearby star. Well, it has Hawking radiation. I don't know how what is going to be. But yeah. Anyway, we are definitely full with. Sorry, our cargo is definitely full, so what we are going to do is go back to home. Actually going to check out if there are any gates nearby. No, very well. In that case, off we fuck. We have a lot of... Oh, look, furry fridge. And we have 400. For some reason. Do I want more blistering cannons? I mean, they look cool. They definitely look cool. With enhanced projectile synthesis. Uh-huh. Can you be more specific? Like, is that a HAL mod? Because otherwise I'm not going to know. Okay, we have Annihilator MLRS and... Obliterator rocket launcher. Which is basically the same. I mean, it fires really fucking fast, not gonna lie. Whereas this fires a salvo, so there are differences, of course. This is more pressure. This is more not pressure. Even if we say so. Okay, snake, a PC from the ludic path. Sure. I'm going to take your snake. Roxasha PC. Haven't heard of those. Piranyok sieve. From Iron Shell, apparently. Sure. Gallant PC, I know that they kind of suck. I mean, if you have a lot of them, they don't, but otherwise they will. And to be perfectly honest, if you need anything to be amassed for your shit to work, then it's not really that useful. Could you build faster? Also, what about terraforming? 4 fucking days. I'm going to wait for that. I'm definitely waiting for that. Possibly around here, just doing circles. Because I don't want to go too far. Just to go back. Lol. Very good, terraforming complete. Okay, let's make it habitable. World type allows for mild climate. Well, that's problematic. It's not toxic. Yeah. Shit. So the last thing I could do is make it into a frozen world instead of a cryovolcanic one, but I think that would fuck with my thing. So atmosphere processors are unneeded. They are not going to help anymore. Ismala sling I'm going to keep because it helps with increasing food output. I don't really have anything else, so yay! Hard drinking spacer. I don't need your Colossus. Angry woman in expensive suit. No. What do you want? Ionos class battle cruiser. We are going to finish soon, so I'm just going to check the fuck is an Ionos class. So it's definitely not a destroyer or a frigate, so I can just go and I spy with my little eye a incursion intimidation Ingress Ionos class battle cruiser. There you go. Large energy to medium missile. For small energy, for medium energy. Yeah, seems like a lesser battleship. Heavy phase skimmer teleports the ship forward in the direction it's traveling. Displacement takes slightly longer to initiate and requires a slight pause before it can be reused. The system slowly builds up three chargers, which can then be expended in short order. Okay, it's basically phase skimmer, but worse for some reason. Like, guys. Radiant class exists, you don't need to be like fidgety around it. Especially when the maintenance costs fucking 40 per month. Weirdly enough, it only needs fucking 3 fuel per light year. Yeah. So, what can we do with it? Well, seemingly everything is forward facing, so that's not a problem. However, one large and four mediums, I don't think that's a battle cruiser, like just a medium cruiser, an actual cruiser, not a battleship in a bit a cruiser slapped onto the face. I mean, it's 220 ordnance points. I don't really consider battleships, I mean capital class ships capital unless they have like close to 300 or something. I say that Onslaught might be even worse. Nope, 360. Paragon, 370 was the other one, the Conquest. Yeah, capital ships under 300 are not capital ships. That's my take. Anything on the fuck are you? Two large energy, okay, two medium missile. Three small hybrid phase field, delicate machinery, high maintenance and safety removal. Why do? It has relativity drive, which allows the user to gravely slow time around it and cause double the combat rating degradation while active. So, relativity drive plus phasing in makes it really fast. I presume. I mean, the two large energies basically just make it work. Like, imagine having two large plasma spitter thingamajigs. What is that? Two small sticks. Marks mining drill. Oh! Basically retrofit that lusher. Ah yeah, this was what I was looking at. The destroyer with a large missile. It's weird. Yoink. Alright, dock sidebar. No. I just realized that I really don't need it. Anyway. Let's go back home, drop down our shit. Ah! I misclicked, I wanted it earlier. God damn it. Mercantile convoy. Very well. Terraforming options? More farmland? More farmland! Fucking mercenaries. No. I spy with my little eyes some shit. What are you? Heavy modular small mer. Cheap. Fighter suppression. Actually costs flux to what are you? Verolica field disruptor. I mean, 30 degrees field, which slows down and damages fighters and missiles. I don't know what are you, but I'm buying you. Laser torpedo, I already have a lot of those. Double torogial, yeah. These look weird, like short range, okay, fighter suppression, so yeah. 60 per shot, 75 per thingamajig, per 75 damage per missile, plus same with EMP. Do I have any of these? Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to check what this farmer does. 200 per missile, and there is just straight up. Well, it's fragmentation, so. It's only 50 in that case, but a lot of missiles slash small craft, aka fighters, don't really have armor. Now granted it costs the same, so yeah, and also costs a flux to shoot, which is weird. I guess it's better against proper fighters and or whatever the fuck they are called. Frigates. Doop, 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 doop. Do I have any AI cores? Yes, I do. Sword, and let's have all these weapons. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is put that very nice. No, not that one. Oh, large missile, not large medium. Sorry, energy. Very well. Lesson learned, I guess. Okay, I guess. I mean, whatever the fuck I'm shooting needs some kind of tracking. So I'm thinking about atropi. What are the two mediums going to be? Actually, that I not necessarily need. That I definitely do. Where are you? Split chambers and maybe weighted rounds? I mean, this combo is cheaper than buying, that. Actually, it's not. It's literally the same. So it goes 30% faster, and I really need this. Fuck. And I need, like, 30 more points. Oh shit, okay. In that case, this is going to be smaller. Like, I could have dust missiles. Sure, sure. Maybe even pilums, but in that case, I don't think they are going to fare very well. Locusts, on the other hand. Yeah, I could try those. Hey, what do I don't need? Well, technically these two. So what should I get on these? Well, definitely something that costs 10 or less. I don't know the range of our main weapons, so I'm going to go for medium range. So 700 or something. Two remnant phase lenses doesn't sound bad. So it has EMP now, that's the difference, okay. Don't know if I want to get behind that though. We'll see. Actually, what should these be? Something that costs 4. 4 per each. So, PD laser, cap pistol, I mean, it's anti shield. Base assault rifle. Tactical lasers. Of which the remnant one is just straight up better. Okay, it needs more flags, but don't care to be perfectly honest. However, I don't really want any weapon that is... Wait. I cannot use Fiend's Lances because of the turbo magnetic, fuck you. In that case, Storm Blasters? I mean, what I really want is better flux per damage. But this is also a laser, so I don't think so that my current thing is going to help it. Do we have anything that is not a fucking beam? Literally this. Okay, heavy electron rifle. Is it a beam? It's not. Thank fucking God. Now, pulse laser. Since I'm looking for better flux bar damage, maybe one of these. Or maybe two of these. I mean, I don't really have any other options. Because these are beams. And those suck. So we could go with Storm Blasters. Sadly, they are really suppression. I'm going to go with two of those and retain whatever cost for weapons do we have. Except, not really. I mean, we could make it work. We could definitely make it work. Sadly, it's even worse range-wise than the other things I have, so I'd rather not. Also, fucking beam weapons, get the hell out. Only thing I could think of is either the cap pistol or the base rifle. None of them particularly good. Especially on the flux per damage front. Plasma cutters, maybe? Sadly, it only has limited charges, so it's not really going to work. I mean, these are at least flux efficient. Maybe these. It's a beam already. IR pulse lasers are not bad as well. Like, or 500. Shield pike. I mean, not bad, but I don't really have multiples of them. Oh, hi. Very well. Hope it's going to work. If it's not, then we are fucked. We cost 13, so where is the phase thing? I need an actual phase fighter against it. Oh, there you go. Combat salvage, escort carrier, phase strike destroyer. Very well. Let's see if it can actually fuck it. Well, sadly the main gun is not going to work too well. Simply because, yeah, split chambers works really well with low flux per damage weapons, but sadly, they actually need to do damage. So, like, the only thing I can think of that is actually worthwhile is the Salon Blaster, since, you know, it fucks. Also, it's an actual blaster. Let's try now. Ow. How much for an iron pulsar? No, not iron beam, iron pulsar. 11. Very well. You are no PD pulsars. You are Iron Brothers the moment I fucking found them. How much for expanded magazines? 5. In that case, let's try this. You know what, let's go against that one. Siege Destroyer, you say?
Thank you.
Well, it has a little bit of problem with you know. Wait. Yes, I'm at home. Don't worry, Zoltan. You can put it back now. Also this. What you can also take from the storage is, yes, your next Bernard. How jolly. So I can put back this into store. Do I have it? Yeah, supposedly. No, supposedly. Oh yeah, I need militarized subsystems added in there. Confirm. Let's add efficiency overhaul back and put that gravity flux conduit on there as well. There you go. And it's empty. Yay! Also. Nice. So now we can have a whooping 20,000 fuel at our fleet. Nice. And we are 55 minutes already over the freaking 2 hour mark. Very well. In that case, I think we are done. Yeah, it seems everything I bought has already been delivered. Yep. Though I could definitely put more papillons in there. No, it's full actually. Okay. In that case, let me put papillons in here. As it's supposed to. Terraforming options, yeah, I just started that. Manage colony. Storage, have these. And we have started tech mining. Yay! In that case, we are slowly going to build up our farmland and make this planet a paradise. After the tech mining, I think I'm going to go for commerce. Which is supposedly helps, supposedly. And yeah, that's kinda it. So, thank you guys for watching. I was Zelenius, and I hope to see you back in my den with more Star Sector. Hopefully we are actually going to start kicking some ass now. Or wait, no. I have a lot of money, I'm going to start building more colonies now. Also go back and try to make the planet come back to this system because I really fucking need it. Anyway, bye!